Miss Robson, are you ready to go? Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen, special guests, parents, teachers, families and friends, and all those watching our live stream at home, welcome to the 63rd Asquith Boys High School presentation ceremony for 2023. My name is Craig Phillip, and I will be your MC for today's event. It's great to have the whole school back with us live and in person in the hall after the disruption of previous years. In the interest of maintaining the flow and quality of the event, could the guests in the hall please ensure that electronic devices are switched to silent? And would you all please stand for the entrance of the official party? May I ask you to please remain standing for the national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. So we say welcome to the student leadership team for 2024, who will be your compares for this ceremony. And I now hand you over to our school captain, Jaden Mark.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our 63rd annual presentation day. My name is Jaden Mark, and it is my privilege to have been elected school captain of Ascough Boys School for 2024. As such, I, along with Vice Captain Samuel Kingston and Senior Prefect Riley Heisman, will be your host today. I would now like to invite Davis Stanley to say acknowledgement of the country.
On behalf of the Ascough Boys High School community, I would like to recognise the traditional custodians of this land, the Darug and Gurungai people. We pay respects to their ancestors and elders and extend that respect to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders people, both past, present and emerging. We acknowledge and uphold their connections to the land and continuing relationships to the country, now and forever.
Thank you, Davis. A sincere welcome to students, parents and family and special guests from the local and wider community. Whether you are joining us from the hall or online, I would like to thank you all for your continued commitment to our school. This is the third live stream of our presentation ceremony, and today is a very special occasion for all of us. Today we welcome our special guest, Mr. Julian Lisa, MP, member of Four Barara, the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddock, Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, Mr. Nathan Tilbury, Councillor of Hornsby Shire Council, Chief Petty Officer David McGovern, Ms. Dawn Kilkelly, President of PNC Association, Mr. Christopher Kent, President of ABHS Old Boys, Mrs. Julie Debray, President of the Hornsby Shire Historical Society, Mr. Dennis Hogan, President of the Rotary Club of Hornsby, Mr. Brian Engert, President of Hornsby Lions Club, Mr. Fook Vo, Pharmacist of Hornsby Curry Chemist, Mr. Bill Holland, Owner of Hornsby 24/7 Gym, and Mr. Peter Goodridge, Senior Mason, Hornsby and Karingai Masonic Association. This ceremony is about celebrating the wonderful achievements of the students of Ascough Boys High School in the areas of academia, sport, citizenship, community service and culture, which this year has been particularly outstanding. We would like to especially thank all of our supporters who have generously provided prizes for the boys, even if they cannot be with us today. I'd now like to invite our principal, Mr. Bryce Grant, to give his principal's address for 2023.
Thank you, Jaden, and thank you, Davis, for that introduction and acknowledgement of country. I too would like to begin today by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we gather and pay my respect to their elders past and present. I extend that respect to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders, people here today. Good morning to students, staff, award winners, parents, and our special guests who have all been invited and, more importantly, able to join and share in this important occasion with us. To all guests present or joining us via streaming, we welcome you to our 63rd annual presentation day, where we acknowledge and celebrate all of our academic, sporting, leadership, school achievements and successes in relation to Ascough Boys High School new school values of respect, responsibility and excellence for 2023. I'm excited that this morning we continue to celebrate that connection with those school values of respect, responsibility and excellence. And this year alone, we had over 70% of our students or cohorts achieve merits or the equivalent due to their performances both in and out of the classroom. And we look forward to enhancing this initiative in 2024 and beyond. As is the case each and every year, there are challenges both in and out of the classroom that are presented to our students and staff, be that in the constant pursuit of creating, teaching and engaging programs, specifically for boys, developing and implementing successful wellbeing programs and initiatives, or in creating the very best possible learning environments for all our students to ultimately achieve success and access to the best resources for that they will then be possible, not probable, it will be highly probable that they will achieve its success, not just possible. Again in 2023, as a school and community, we have all risen to these challenges and zeroed in on the major focus, educating and supporting our students in and out of the classroom. I'm excited to be able to celebrate and acknowledge all that our students achieved in 2023, be that academic, sporting, or leadership at Asquith Boys High School. I'm extremely proud of the entire school community and the manner that everyone has responded to challenges and the many adjustments that were often received or communicated at short notice this year. We eagerly await Thursday when our Year 12 HSC results for 2023 will be received. As well, for the first time as a school, we will receive their ATAR results as well. It's important that we give special mention to that outgoing Year 12 class. We're excited that 36 of them applied for university entry, with 18 receiving early entry via the school recommendation scheme. And we can confirm that 11 of those successfully received their first preference, with 4 going into teaching, which is exciting. Also in the Year 12 cohort, Daniel McPherson received the honour of his major work, being nominated for the music production encore. NAPLAN results were well above state, similar school averages for Year 7 in reading, numeracy and writing, and even stronger results for our Year 9 with reading 8% above, numeracy 17% above, and grammar and punctuation an incredible 25% above state average. For the second year running, we won the Maths in Surveying competition at Homebush, and this year it was Cameron Searles. And Kai Sheba was selected as one of 75 students nationally to go to the Maths Summer School Forum in Canberra, which will be run in January in 2024. It's commonly known fact that Asquith Boys High School students' success goes well beyond the academic achievements to all aspects of school life, be that sport, leadership and community. Our dedication from school staff to promote numerous opportunities that ensure that our students are known, valued, challenged, supported, can be best and they can be in every opportunity that is presented to them. In sport, CHS Lawn Bowls champion, we had the CHS Lawn Bowls champion in Ethan Scott Brannigan, with Jack Summer Hayes and Harrison Volmos Rivriana in the CHS rugby champion side. At CHS State Swimming, Jensen Goodchild finished the incredible third in the 400 metre freestyle and placed sixth with his relay team in the 17 years relay final. His teammates were Jake Sheeran, Jack Mooney and Cooper Goodchild. Kobe Jenkins, Jake Hawkins, Marley Jenkins and Sayra Nasio competed in the CHS Athletics relay final, where they ran the fourth fastest time in the heat and finished seventh in the final. In zone cross country, we had an incredible 8 students finish in the top 5 across all ages. And Declan Lees ultimately went on to compete at CHS, finishing 40th in the 17 years 6K event. Jordan Lowe selected in New South Wales Intermediate, and Kieran Mark in the junior New South Wales baseball sides. Our KO softball side received a last minute invitation to the CHS Championships, where they were narrowly defeated by the eventual semi-finalists, Merriweather High School, before winning the plate competition, achieving 9th in the state. As always, in our winter grade sport, we achieved an incredible 6th grade winter zone grand final teams, with 3 being victorious. And in the summer, an incredible further 9 grand final teams, with 7 being victorious. As the smallest school in the zone competition, we continue to succeed despite our size, and it's largely due to the passion and dedication of our wonderful coaches. To them, I say thank you on behalf of the school and students for your time and dedication. It'd be remiss of me not to mention or acknowledge Mr. Jones, our great sports coordinator this morning, for his organisation, administration and drive for our students to participate and represent Asquith Boys High School each and every week in the grade sport competition. Only last week was he recognised for his service and dedication to sport with an Outstanding Sports Organisers Award presented to him via the New South Wales School Sports Unit. Congratulations, Mr. Jones. In school and community performance, this year we collected gold and silver awards at the Australian Schools Band and Orchestra Festival for the concert and wind and stage band, as well as performing numerous fetes and festivals around the metropolitan and rural areas. Our school choir performed at the New South Wales School Spectacular, and Robbie Morgan was selected for an individual role at that event. In Term 3, we saw the return of our annual walkathon, and despite the inclement weather, proved to be an excellent success, fundraising over $13,000 for Flying Doctors and Legacy. In Term 4, the school prefects selected an initiative to promote White Ribbon Day, highlighting an extremely important issue, not only to all communities, but from all males more specifically. 2023 highlighted highly anticipated Year 10 ski trip returned, and in 2024, Asquith Boys High School will again travel internationally to Japan for a cultural and sporting tour, with 34 extremely excited students eagerly awaiting the end of Term 1 next year. And over the past week, from Year 7 to 11, we've had the opportunity to attend and enjoy wellbeing days as a reward for effort in learning and personal growth over the last 12 months, as well as our very first Year 9-10 Commerce Market Day, which was a success. In leadership, our prefects represented Asquith Boys High School at Parliament House with Matt Keane. They also had the privilege of recently welcoming Federal Shadow Minister for Finance, Jane Hume, and our local Borough member, who is joining us today, Julian Lisa, to showcase and present to the ministers our proposal for our much-needed multi-purpose centre at Asquith Boys High School. This year, our prefects proudly continued our tradition of representing the school at Anzac and Remembrance Day services, undertaking major and invitational roles at these important and celebrated services. And our Year 12 prefect, Ethan Scott Brannigan, received a Blues Award for his contribution and representative service to Lawn Bowls. Ethan received this award from former Asquith Boys High School student and 2012 Olympian Daniel Armanart, who has agreed to return as our guest speaker for our High School High Achievers Assembly in 2024. These are only some of the very many opportunities that our students have to showcase their talents, while reaffirming and continuing the excellent reputation of Asquith Boys High School students that continues to grow amongst the broader community. This year alone in 2023, as a student body from 7 to 12, you have all been exceptional, ensuring that your learning and your educational growth and development continued throughout the year. As well as celebrating our strong individual academic performances, it is worth noting that the introduction of the mobile phone policy, off and away, all day, has proven highly successful, not only increasing student engagement and focus within the classroom, but there has been a significant increase in the number of students actively engaging physical activities at recess and lunchtimes. In 2023, our school resources and facilities continue to be renewed and improved. Our students, with respect to their learning and classroom engagement, in the past 5 years, we've received funding for five new science labs, new toilet facilities. Every block in the school has had its roofs and bells renewed. Construction of a futsal court with lighting, new basketball courts that have been resurfaced and have two additional rings, the entry pathway to the school, the new audio visual for the hall, and every classroom and staff room being air conditioned. And an exam provisions room known as Room 1. After the Christmas holidays, we will return to further improvements of our facilities with 3 brand new woodwork rooms worth almost $1 million in design, and containing state-of-the-art equipment for our students to access and complete their works. This year, our construction and school-to-work students also completed the retaining structures along the edge of the oval, renewed the oval grandstand, completed the reception area on Jersey Street, which I'm eager to utilise for the very first time this morning after our assembly. Seating around the trees in the quad, replacing the decking in the TAS area, with further construction plans for 2024 in the initial stage of planning, we thank Mr. Robson, Mr. Legenstra, and Mr. Moskos for their continued support and participation in these programs and initiatives. It is important at this time that our community farewell and acknowledge the contribution from contribution from staff that have left or are leaving at the end of the year. This includes Ms. Claudia Camacho, Ms. Elsa Young, Ms. Amy Lee, and Mr. Sam Saliva, who will all be missed as dedicated educators for your sons while at Asquith Boys High School. We thank them and wish them the very best. With these changes comes new staff appointments, and in 2023, we have already welcomed the permanent appointment of Mr. Cabrera, Ms. Prudnick, Mr. Campbell, and Ms. Lee, with Ms. Brianna Hale in TAS, Ms. Jessang in Maths, and Ms. Marina Trompeter in English, all joining our staff in a temp capacity. In 2024, we'll also welcome Ms. Michelle Shaw in English and Ms. Layla Rizzulli in Science. Today, we are excited to celebrate not just those who I've already mentioned, but so many more students who have excelled academically and continue to impress with their willingness and desire to participate to the very best they can. Always adopting the philosophy that, even for the brightest among us, there is always something more to learn. Their success are only possible due to the dedication and generosity of our professional and passionate teaching staff who are committed to pursuing excellent learning opportunities for our boys. As extraordinary educators, they aim to provide the extra for all their students each and every day. Today, I would also like to acknowledge and thank all parents for your involvement in the school and being wonderful advocates for all that we do at Asquith Boys High School, not only within the school, but the broader and local communities. Thank you to the wonderful PNC committee for their generosity in 2023. A special thank you to Ms. Dawn Kelly as president for her unwavering support and service to the school as president over the last 4 years. A big thank you to all the parents who attended Zoom PNC meetings this year. Your contribution to our extensive grounds, as well as the provision for us to recently purchase important faculty technology resources from electric drums, screen and lighting consoles, robotic arms, data loggers, and the much needed new data panels to replace aging projectors, as well as rotating and movable cameras for our assemblies. All the while continuing to support the school through funding initiatives such as Breakfast Club. It is always appreciated that the parent community supports Asquith Boys High School in all of our important whole school curricula and extracurricular areas. So thank you. I would also like to thank our outstanding and hardworking non-teaching and support staff. We're extremely lucky to have a wonderful and talented team who are dedicated to the service of your sons and the staff at Asquith Boys High School. Finally, a big thank you to the organisers for their efforts in coordinating today's presentation assembly. Ms. Booker, Ms. Holder, Mr. Phillip, Ms. Robson, Ms. Henry, Mr. Cabrera, Ms. Parker, Ms. Timmons, and the many other wonderful staff for their support and organisation. 2024 brings another exciting year for Asquith Boys High School. As an educational institution committed to excellence in addressing the learning needs of our boys in this community, in 2024, we're excited to welcome 120 new Year 7 students to our wonderful school. Finally, I am truly privileged to be the principal of Asquith Boys High School. This year has presented its challenges, but ultimately has been an enriching one where I've again learned and shared so much from everyone involved in this wonderful school. Boys, staff, and parents, to conclude 2023, I am, as always, proud of everyone, as you all should be of yourselves and what you have achieved collectively in 2023. Each and every day, I'm impressed and inspired by all the students, staff, and parents who make up this wonderful community. Congratulations to all of you on your efforts and performances in 2023, and we eagerly look forward and excited and amazed to what you will achieve in 2024. Thank you. Thank you. In a break from tradition and our regular formal proceedings, I'd like to take this opportunity to announce our School Administration Staff Award. If I could invite Ms. Ronald to the stage to present this newly named award in 2023. It was with a heavy heart that our much loved and respected SAS staff member, Deb Seifert, passed away in August after an extensive battle with cancer. Deb was the first person that many of our staff and students would see of a morning when signing in for the day. She was also the first person that many of our senior students would see when they presented of a morning for their late arrivals or when they signed out early of an afternoon. Deb's print room was a safe place. So for many of the staff at Asquith Boys High School, it was a place that she made everyone feel comfortable, safe and welcome. She was extremely knowledgeable with all things DET policy and practice, and it is still common to hear the staff say, Deb would have done, or Deb would have saved it, or Deb was able to do. Deb possessed an ability to make everyone laugh and feel happy. With Christmas upon us, apart from her family, this was an important and special time of the year for Deb. Not having her around to decorate the office only reinforces not having her with us that much more significant. While our loss is nowhere near as insurmountable as that of her family, we all dearly miss Deb, not only as a colleague, but as a friend, confidant and console to many. Deb was a member of the SAS staff at Asquith Boys from 2006 to 2023 and almost 17 years. Today we would like to announce that the SAS Staff Award be named in honour of Deb, with the inaugural Deb Seifert SAS Award to be presented by colleague and close friend, Karen Ronald. It is my honour and privilege to announce that the inaugural recipient of the Deb Seifert Award for 2023 is Deb Seifert, and we ask that the husband and partner, Daniel, and daughter, Tanisha, come forward to accept the award on behalf of the family.
Thank you, Mr. Grant. The successes that have been such a feature of the year in all areas are due in no small part to the strong and positive leadership which you have shown, providing students at Asquith Boys with exceptional learning opportunities and truly valuing the work of all those under your leadership. Your hard work and care is always greatly appreciated. The early years of high school are exciting, intimidating, and challenging at the same time. It is therefore important to acknowledge students in Year 7 who have achieved success. These awards recognise students for their excellence in their studies and commitment to school and include awards for academic excellence, attendance, learning area achievement and the PNC Encouragement Award. I'd like to invite Mr. Max Darwin, the Year 7 Advisor, to announce the Year 7 Awards.
Thank you, Riley. Good morning to parents, guests, and students present today. I've been fortunate enough to help guide Year 7 through the transition to high school and watch them over the year as they have grown and developed. I'm incredibly proud of them and their achievements, and I would like to recognise them today. I would like to invite Mrs. Dawn Kelly, the President of the PNC Association, to present the awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. Jack Earl, highly commended in 7A. Darcy Ford, Stage 4 Artist of the Year in Visual Arts. Mike Gallagher, highly commended in 7B. Jake Hawkins, highly commended in 7E. Eric Lung, first in 7A. William Motum, Bronze Principal Medallion. Oliver Quinton, first in 7B. Geordie Roach, PNC Encouragement Award. Well done, Geordie. Harry Simpson, Perfect Attendance Award. Grayson Walsh, first in 7E, Stage 4 Artist of the Year in Visual Arts. And Beau Winham, Hornsby and Kringai Masonic Association Award. Please join me in congratulating the Year 7 Award winners on their achievements.
Thank you, Mr. Darwin and Ms. Kilkelly. It is also important to acknowledge the Year 8 students who continue to take advantage of all that Asquith Boys has to offer. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Mr. Kim Timmons, Year 8 Advisor, to announce the awards.
Thank you, Riley. Good morning, parents, fellow teachers, and students. I would firstly like to acknowledge traditional owners of the land that we are gathering on today, Guringai and Darug country. I pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging, and any First Nations people here today. As our second year at Asquith Boys comes to a close, my pride has only grown in these young men with their efforts and achievements throughout the year. They have grown both academically and physically, highlighted by the short work they made of the pizza at yesterday's Wellbeing Day. I have been able to get to know them better, whether it be fortnightly at our cafe club catch-ups or just passing through the corridors or in the playground. They are funny, extremely smart, and becoming more quick-witted, the Asquith way. These young men continue to show they are talented, intelligent, and hardworking, who I encourage to reach for the stars and not take the easy way out. Year 8 should be very proud of their efforts this year. I'd like to invite Mr. Dennis Hogan, President of the Rotary Club Hornsby, to present the first of these awards. Please hold your applause till we reach the end. Jairus Barakowskis, highly commended in 8H and the Bronze Principal Medallion. Archer Barton, first in 8E. Archie Bennett, the PNC Encouragement Award. Ali Bilgrami, first in 8B. He's not with us today. Oh, sorry, you are. Hello, Ali. Benjamin Bingham, Junior Drama Student of the Year and School Service Hall Crew Award. Sorry, Ben also got the Bronze Principal Medallion. Jack Bock, School Service Hall Crew Award.
Would that be Dad? Hold on, mate.
Jason Bright, the Bronze Principal Medallion. Tommy Saran, School Service Hall Crew Award. Lachlan Coombs, Band Encouragement Award and School Service Hall Crew Award. Haruki Fung, School Service Library Award. Sean Jang, first in 8H. Kobe Jenkins, highly commended in music, bronze principal medallion. Cooper Lowe, bronze principal medallion. Alexander McCruckus, first in 8S, highly commended in creative design and school service library award. Angus Michelle, school service hall crew award. Gabriel Miss Kelly was given the Hornsby and Ku-ring-gai Masonic Association Award, and I know he's not with us today. Ryan Mooney, highly commended in 8S. Robert Morgan, first in music. Thank you, Mr. Dennis Hogan. I now invite Mr. Julian Lessar, MP, Member for Barara, to present the next award. Darcy Nash Krause, School Service Hall Crew Award. Edward Neat, Stage 4 Artist of the Year in Visual Arts. Riley Pierce, first in Photography Digital Media, Christopher Kent All-Star Photography Award, School Service Hall Crew Award, and Bronze Principal Medallion. Thank you. Jacob Rapsey, highly commended in 8B. Luke Reddy, Bronze Principal Medallion. Jack Robson, highly commended in 8E. Marion Justine Redellis, highly commended in Photography Digital Media. Braden Searles, first in Football Development Squad. And I don't think this is a typo, Matthew Searles, first in Football Development Squad. Benji Smart, first in 8A. Don't think he's coming. Jackson Spedder, School Service Hall Crew Award. Davis Stanley, first in Creative Design, Miller Family Junior Technology Award and School Service Hall Crew Award. Macklin Stranack, Bronze Principal Medallion. Good job, Matt. Charlie Taggart, Bronze Principal Medallion. I'm as shocked as you are. Charlie Thwaites, Bronze Principal Medallion. James Von Borneman, highly commended in 8A. And I don't think he's with us either today. Please congratulate Year 8 students on their achievements.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Timmins, Mr. Hogan, and Mr. Lesser. We have certainly seen a lot of very deserving Stage 4 award winners so far today. The band program at Asquith Boys is well established, and we have a junior and senior stage band. We also have a joint concert band and wind ensemble with our sister school, Asquith Girls. Firstly, however, I take great pleasure in introducing to you the stage band who will perform for your enjoyment, Better Get Hit in Your Soul.
Thank you. Thanks to the stage band for that wonderful performance. We'll now move to the Stage 5 Awards and acknowledge the Year 9 students who have demonstrated excellence in academic achievement, learning, citizenship, and commitment. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Mr. Horro and Mr. Broom to announce the awards.
Thank you, Samuel, and hello, everyone. Firstly, well done to the stage band on that wonderful performance. That was excellent. Unfortunately, Mr. Melrose, the Year 9 advisor, could not be here with us today, and he sends his apologies. So I've been given the honour of recognising the Year 9 students who will be receiving academic awards for their continued excellence throughout the year. I'd like to invite the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddick, the Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, to present the first of these awards, and I'd please ask everyone to hold their applause until the end. First of the Year 9 Awards, Harvey Barton, first in Building and Construction and first in Physical Activity and Sports Studies. Harrison Brownlow, first in Information and Software Technology, and Harrison is also receiving the School Service Hall Crew Award. Well done. Boston Cameron, first in PDHPE. Liam Debney, first in Mathematics 5.2, first in Mandatory History, first in Commerce, and highly commended in Science. Raphael Gacius, highly commended in Information and Software Technology. Edward Gorris, highly commended in Building and Construction. John Hansworth, first in music. Lachlan Heath, highly commended in Mathematics 5.3, highly commended in Timber, and highly commended in Science. Well done. Gabrielle Hewken, first in Metal. Reese Jaffrey, who's unfortunately away, received highly commended in Maths 5.1. Bryce Kerr, first in Elective Geography, highly commended in Elective History, highly commended in Commerce, and Bryce also received the PNC Encouragement Award. Well done. And Jesse Loffel. Is Jesse here? Yep. First in Elective History, first in Science, first in English, first in commended, highly commended in Music, highly commended in food technology. Jesse's also received the Bronze Principles Medallion Award and is the Junior Musician of the Year. I think that one does deserve its own round of applause. Well done. That's it for the first round of Year 9 Awards, and I'd like to thank the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddick. And now we'd like to invite Mr. Brian Edgert, President of the Lions Club Barawa, to come to the stage to present the next of the Year 9 Awards. Archie Mayer, first in Visual Arts and Bronze Principals Medallion Award. Reese McNaught, Bronze Principals Medallion Award. Noah Nash Krauss, highly commended in Mandatory History, highly commended in Mandatory Geography, and highly commended in English. Well done, mate. Jacob Neave, highly commended in Mandatory History, highly commended in Mandatory Geography, and highly commended in English.
Well done, Jake.
Thomas Osborne, highly commended in English. Evan Parise receives the Hornsby and Ku'ring'i Masonic Associations Award. Joshua Passafaro, first in food technology. Well done, Josh. Riley Piper, first in mathematics 5.1. Joe Sheba received a bronze principal's medallion. Japjot Singh, highly commended in mathematics 5.2. Royce Taylor, highly commended in metal. Well done, Royce. Ellis Tuddy, first in mathematics 5.3, highly commended in PDHPE, highly commended in physical activities and sports studies. Well done. And finally, the last of our awards for year nine is Henry Williams, who received first in humanities geography and first in art medal. Well done. Could we give, please have a big round of applause for all of our year nine recipients.
Thank you, Mr. Broom and Brian Engert and Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddock. It is wonderful to celebrate the deserving winners of Year 9 for their outstanding learning, citizenship and commitment. It is now my pleasure to recognise excellence in our Year 10 student body. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Mr. Matt Campbell, Year 10 Advisor, to announce the awards.
Good morning, students, teachers, parents, and other members of the Asquith Boys High School community. Over the past term, I have had the privilege of filling in as Year 10 Year Advisor while Mr. Bonza has been on leave. Even in my short time in the role, I have been thoroughly impressed with their development, growing not only as students, but young men who embody the school values of respect, responsibility, and excellence. This development has been exemplified by our award winners today, whether excelling in their studies, on the sporting pitch, or consistently bringing a determined and encouraging attitude to all facets of their life at Asquith Boys High School. I would like to start by inviting Mr. Peter Goodrich, Senior Mason of the Hornsby-Ku'ringai Mason Association, to present the first of the Year 10 awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. First up, Nathan Adams, first in mandatory history. Matthew Argent, the School Service Hall Crew Award. Nicholas Blanch, School Service Hall Crew Award. James Burt, first in Information and Software Technology and the Band Achievement Award. Renil Kabutian, highly commended in Visual Arts, highly commended in Food Technology, and highly commended in English. Connor Clark, first in Building and Construction, and the School Service Hall Crew Award. Harry Dolden, first in Food Technology, highly commended in Mandatory History, highly commended in Commerce, and the School Service Hall Crew Award. Dylan Drake, highly commended in Metalwork. Ben Eisner, first in Art Metal, and the School Service Hall Crew Award. Mitchell Heaton, first in Mathematics 5.1. Tyson Hong, the Perfect Attendance Award. Lucas Hunter, highly commended in Building and Construction. Rylan Jarman, the PNC Encouragement Award. Joshua Kagerman, highly commended in Information and Software Technology and the Perfect Attendance Award. Patrick Kilkelly, first in Physical Activity and Sports Studies, first in Music, and the School Service Hall Crew Award. Thank you to Mr. Peter Goodrich. I would now invite Mr. Fook Vo from the pharmacist at Hornsby Curry Chemist to present the next award. First, Sunny Lee, first in Science, highly commended in Music, School Service Hall Crew Award, and Junior Science Award of the Year. Byron Lowe, first in Timber. Benjamin Mackey, highly commended in Timber. Toby Menzies-Jackson, first in Mathematics 5.3, first in English, highly commended in Elective History, highly commended in Elective Geography, highly commended in Science, Year 10 High Achievement Award, and the Bronze Principal Medallion. Next, we have Toby Morgan, Drummond Family Peer Tutoring Persistence and Improvement Award. Tyler Morris, highly commended in PDHPE. Noah Muxlow, highly commended in Mathematics 5.2. Oscar Romberg, first in Visual Arts, first in Commerce, School Service Hall Crew Management Award, and the Stage 5 Artist of the Year Award. Cameron Searle, first in Elective History, first in Mandatory Geography, first in Elective Geography, highly commended in Physical Activity and Sports Studies, highly commended in Mathematics 5.3, highly commended in Science, the Year 10 High Achiever Award, highly commended overall, the Junior Mathematician of the Year, and Junior Historian of the Year. Blake Tilley, first in metalwork. Jonathan Treves, first in Mathematics 5.2, highly commended in Mandatory Geography. Tyler Truscott-Jones, first in PDHPE and highly commended in English. Andrew Wardle, highly commended in Mathematics 5.1. And finally, Nathan Zinsley, Hornsby and Ku'ringai Masonic Association Award. Please congratulate all our Year 10 High Achievers.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell, Mr. Peter Goodrich, and Mr. Fook Vo. It is fantastic to see a consistent level of excellence across all learning areas. Now to our next musical item. We welcome for the first time the boys of the junior stage band who will perform Royals, performed by the concert band and wind ensemble.
Thank you.
Thank you for that enjoyable performance. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to Stage 6 Awards. Having just completed Year 11 myself, I can attest to the challenges we have faced as we try and adjust to the high expectations and demands of the HSC. As well as academic demands, many of our students also shine in other areas, including citizenship, commitment of and mastery of practical and vocation skills. To acknowledge Year 11 students who have adapted best to this new reality, I take pleasure in inviting to the stage Year 11 advisor, Miss Anne Fan.
Good morning to teachers, students, and all the family who've made the effort to be here today. I would firstly like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that we are gathering on today and pay my respects to elders past, present, and emerging. As our new Year 12s embark on their final year, I can honestly say that I'm incredibly proud of their growth in character and the resilience that they have shown this year. Adapting to the demands of senior schooling is not an easy task, and at every occasion, these young men continue to show that they are fun, hardworking, and eager to learn, and I'm excited to see where their final year leads them. I would like to invite Mr. Nathan Tilbury, Councillor of Hornsby Shire Council, to present the first set of Year 11 awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. Cameron Benny, PNC Encouragement Award. Jacob Cracknell, School Service Hall Crew Award. Nathan Crump, first in food technology, first in PDHPE. Nathan's not here today. Jake De Silva, first in sport, lifestyle, and recreation.
Hello, congratulations.
Asha DeBerg, highly commended in PDHPE. Asha's not with us today. Max Dempsey, first in construction vet, highly commended in business studies, highly commended in industrial technology, timber. Cameron Dillon, first in English studies. Gavin Estrella, highly commended in chemistry, highly commended in mathematics extension one. Nathan Gates, first in industrial technology timber, Stephen Mason Award for Technology Year 11. Cameron Jins, first in legal studies, highly commended in engineering studies, highly commended in modern history. Pablo Gomez, Work Placement Recognition Award in Construction Vet. Riley Heisman, first in English Extension 1, highly commended in English Advanced. Jinseo Jang, first in Business Studies, first in Chemistry. Highly commended in Biology, highly commended in Mathematics Advanced.
Good job.
Sam Kingston, first in English Standard, first in Hospitality Vet. Charlie Larrymore, highly commended in design and technology. Charlie Ma, highly commended in music one. Thank you, Mr. Nathan Tilbury. I now invite Mrs. Julie Debray, President of the Hornsby Shire Historical Society, to present the next awards. Aidan McClement, highly commended in economics. Julian McClement, Hornsby and Kurungai Masonic Association Award. Aidan McSweeney, first in mathematics standard. Liam Pierce, highly commended in food technology, highly commended in hospitality vet, school service hall crew award. Connor Phillip, highly commended in visual arts, Carolyn Cook painting award in visual arts. Douglas Price, first in visual arts, highly commended in ancient history, highly commended in physics, Stage 5 Artist of the Year, the Jane Sheridan Environmental Science Award. Lachlan Reed, highly commended in investigating science. Sam Riddle, Work Placement Recognition Award in Hospitality Vet. Kai Sheba, first in engineering studies, first in mathematics advance, first in mathematics extension one, first in music one, first in physics, bronze principal's medallion. Tom Salinas, first in ancient history, first in biology, first in English advance, first in modern history, highly commended in legal studies, Hornsby Shire Historical Society Award. Xavier Stacey, first in design and technology. Caleb Stranick, first in investigating science, highly commended in mathematics standard.
Good job. Thank you.
Charlie Streak Warren, first in work studies, highly commended in construction vet.
Good job.
Jack Turner, highly commended in English studies. Sam Warner, highly commended in sport, lifestyle and recreation. Ethan Warren, first in economics, highly commended in English standard. Please congratulate all the Year 11 students on their achievements.
Thank you, Ms. Fan, Mr. Nathan Tilbury, and Mrs. Julie Debray. It is so wonderful to see all the deserving winners in Year 11 and acknowledge their achievements. While Year 12 academic awards were presented at the graduation ceremony, we still need to recognise the excellence of a small few who have been nominated for Learning Area Awards for Year 12. They will be announced by the Year 12 advisor, Ms. Alison Gowthorpe.
Thank you, Jaden, and good morning to all. It's my honour to be on stage today to present these awards to these wonderful young men. They've set a fantastic example for the rest of the school to follow with their commitment to their studies and have displayed excellence in their learning area. Well done. I would like to invite Mr. Christopher Kent, President for the ABHS Old Boys Association, to present these awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. Sean Antrim, Food and Catering Service Award for Year 12. Well done. Eli Gutman, Exceptional HSIE Student of the Year. Congratulations. Jasper Hildebrand, Senior Historian of the Year. Daniel McPherson, Senior Award for Excellence in Music. Ethan Scott Brannigan, the Andrew Bridge Award, Industrial Technology. Timothy von Bornemann, S&S Wholesalers Prize. Good work, Tim. And Vladimir Zuev Elbasha, the Senior Mathematician of the Year and Steffel Prize for Science. Well done, Vlad. Please congratulate these Year 12 students on their achievements.
Thank you, Ms. Gowthorpe and Mr. Kent, and congratulations to the award winners. The Year 12 boys have been role models for us and are a tough act to follow. It is now time for another musical item. The combined jazz combo will now entertain us for performance of Nothing Personal. Thank you to the jazz combo for that great performance. Unfortunately, we missed an award, so I'd like to call Noah Whitehouse to the stage to receive his Year 10 awards for Highly Commended in Metal and School Service Hall Crew to be presented by our MC, Mr. Phillip. All schools value sporting achievement, some more than others. In our school, sport is of paramount importance, satisfying the needs for competition, physical activity, and the building of self-esteem and teamwork. Many students can achieve on the sporting field what they may not be able to achieve academically. In 2023, we are excited to have another wonderful year of sport, including the grade sport competition where we compete against all other schools. All students are able to try out and for a small school, we inevitably exceed expectations in regional, zone, and state level sporting competitions. Here to announce the sporting awards is Grade Sport Coordinator, Mr. Drew Jones.
Thank you, Jaden, and good morning to all. Well, sport has always been an integral part of Asquith Boys High, and we are very proud of our great history and success. Here at Asquith, we provide extensive opportunities for boys to get involved in sport, catering for every individual. From boys who just want to give things a go and like the social aspect of sport, to boys who thrive on competition and go on to higher levels of representation. But it's not only on the field where sport is important. It teaches our boys about morals and ethics, leadership, good sportsmanship and teamwork. And most importantly, it's a chance for our boys to have a lot of fun and build lifelong friendships and skills. And lastly, it's also very important that we recognise and thank all the staff here at Asquith Boys for their wonderful commitment to sport, often going above and beyond to ensure our students receive the many opportunities available to them in the sporting arena. So right now, we're here to recognise and reward the outstanding sporting achievements of our students throughout 2023. I'd now like to invite Dr. Bill Holland up to the stage from 24/7 Gym in Hornsby to present our sport awards. If we could please hold our applause till the end. Our Baseball Player of the Year, Jordan Lowe. I'd also like to recognise Jordan. He's recently been selected as well for Sydney North in softball. So well done. Our Table Tennis Player of the Year, Jodan Ruiz. Our Hockey Player of the Year, Harry Neate. Our Junior Rugby Union Player of the Year, Boston Cameron. Our Rugby Player of the Year, Jaden Mark. Our Futsal Player of the Year, Lincoln Vaughan. Our Junior Football Player of the Year, Logan Booth. Our Football Player of the Year, Julian Cottrell. Our Badminton Player of the Year isn't here today, and that was Rufus Lim. We move on to the Nathan Sonter Memorial Trophy for Lawn Bowls, Ethan Scott Brannigan. Just while he's making his way up, Ethan was our Sportsman of the Year from last year, and he's continued his excellent form. He's actually been, he was selected, shake his hand first, for the New South Wales CHS team that played the School Sport Australia Championships in Tweed Heads earlier this year. And as well as his award, he'll be receiving a New South Wales CHS Blue Endorsement Award, recognising his selection for New South Wales in multiple years. So I think that actually deserves a round of applause as well. He doesn't like being in the spotlight, so you like that. Our Basketball Player of the Year, Cooper Goodchild. I don't think Cooper is with us. Our Ralph Rocket Anderson Memorial Tennis Shield Player of the Year went to Thomas Pullen. He's not here today. Moving on to another one who's not here today. I know he's up in Yamba. That is our Oztag Player of the Year, and that was Josh Hegarty. Our Volleyball Player of the Year, these Year 12s, is Declan Wagshaw, not with us, as well as our Water Polo Player of the Year, Jake Sheeran. Which leaves us with our most prestigious sporting award, and it is my absolute pleasure to announce that our Sportsman of the Year for 2023, and I'll talk a little bit about him as he makes his way up onto the stage, is Jensen Goodchild. Now, Jensen, over the years that he's been at Asquith Boys High School, he's had great success in the pool, and 2023 was no different. Swimming is a sport that takes a tremendous amount of commitment, discipline, and hard work in order to attain success. A lot of unseen hours chasing the black line at training goes into the sport, and Jensen should be very proud of his achievements. In 2023, we'll start with the Zone Swimming Championships. Jensen was first in the 400 metre freestyle, second in the 200 metre free, second in the 100 metre backstroke, and second in the 200 individual medley. He then got third in the 100 breaststroke and the 100 butterfly. That is to go with his second place as part of the open age 4x50 metre freestyle relay team. And that all added up, and he's got the trophy with him there, to Jensen being crowned our zone age champion for the open age division. He then went on to Sydney North, where he was fifth in the 100 metre backstroke, fourth in the 200 metre freestyle, and the 200 metre individual medley. And once again, they went third place as part of the open age 4x50 metre freestyle relay team. And he keeps going to New South Wales CHS Swimming Championships, where he was third in the under 17s 400 metre freestyle, and our open age relay team came sixth at New South Wales, which is an amazing achievement. Jensen then finished his schoolboy swimming at New South Wales All-School Swimming Championships, where he was fifth in the 400 metre freestyle. A fantastic list of results for Jensen, and we look forward to seeing what he can do in 2024. I think he deserves a big round of applause. That concludes my presentations for sports today. Please once again join me in congratulating all of our recipients for an amazing 2023.
Thank you, Mr. Jones and Dr. Bill Holland. This next group of awards recognises students who have demonstrated their abilities in specific areas. After a rigorous selection process, they have been offered scholarships. I call on the head teacher of teaching and engagement, Miss Susie Desmond, to announce these awards, which will be presented by Mr. Grant.
Good morning, everyone. The scholarship process this year was very, very competitive. We had more than 20 applicants that put themselves forward, and they were all endorsed by the head teachers. So there were some wonderful, wonderful students that missed out, as is the way sometimes in life, and hopefully we do congratulate them on putting themselves forward, and hopefully it was a really good learning experience for them and they can take that onto something in the future, and it'll be a useful process for those who missed out as well. But today we're here to celebrate the scholarship recipients. We'll start with the Mervyn Brown Senior Academic Scholarship for English, which goes to Toby Menzies Jackson. Toby is an enthusiastic and dedicated English student who enjoys reading and composing a variety of texts. He achieved outstanding results this year. His final mark in English was 98%. So Toby is a very worthy recipient of our English scholarship for 2024. Well done, Toby. Next up is our mathematics scholarship. Cameron Searle is an excellent mathematics student. He scored the highest grade, which is an A10 for maths on his ROSA. He also placed first in the maths in surveying competition, which was contested across dozens of schools by hundreds of students. So that was a very big achievement. Cameron plans to study advanced and extension maths next year and is interested in pursuing a career in finance. And he is a very worthy recipient of the mathematics scholarship for 2024. Well done, Cameron. What a sweaty. And on to science. Sunny has been the standout student in science this year, excelling in all his tasks and achieving outstanding results. Next year, he's looking to study the trio of chemistry, physics, and bio, and is committed to improving his understanding of difficult scientific concepts, already looking into quantum physics. Sunny is a very worthy recipient of the Science Scholarship for 2024. Well done, Sunny. Taz is up next. Now, Taz is an area that has, it's very diverse, so this was quite hotly contested because students applied across different subjects. The scholarship did go to Renil Kabuthian, and his area of interest is food tech and hospitality. Renil is an outstanding student who has demonstrated consistent work ethic throughout the year. He's a very keen chef and he experiments with cuisine and flavours at home and tries them out on his family. He's demonstrated his commitment to the TAS faculty through hard work in food technology and also volunteering for numerous events. His interview was fantastic. It really did blow us away, his knowledge and preparation that he did. And he is a very, very worthy recipient of this TAS Scholarship Award for 2024. Well done, Renil. Now we're on to PDHPA. Tyler Truscott-Jones is this year's sports captain and he's heavily involved in a number of sporting teams across the school. He's a leader among his peers and has produced consistently excellent results in PDHPA, finishing the year ranked first. Tyler is interested in becoming a physiotherapist when he finishes school and will study PDHPA next year. Tyler is a worthy recipient of the PDHPA scholarship for 2024. Well done, Tyler. On to Hizzy. Hizzy was also, very tightly contested because there is different areas in Hizzy and we had people apply for geography and more from a business angle. And we did choose Nathan Adams, who is a keen history student and has chosen both ancient and modern history for the senior years. He is hoping to be a history teacher when he finishes school, which we love, and he wants to share his love of history with future generations. In a highly contested category, Nathan is a worthy recipient of our Hizzy Scholarship for 2024. Well done, Nathan. Good job, sweetie. For Kappa this year, the scholarship is in the music category and it is awarded to Patrick Kilkelly. Paddy is a drummer and he's looking to pursue a career in audio production. He plays in a band outside school called The Third Ridge, and he is a very, very good drummer, and he's looking to hone in his skills, working on that, especially his performance skills. He performed a piece, which I think he also performed today for us, which is very daunting because he was just drumming to an audience of three people, but he did a wonderful job, and he is a very worthy recipient of our Kappa Scholarship for 2024. Well done, Paddy. Good job. And our two instrumental band scholarship winners you would have seen on stage today performing in the band. It takes a lot of dedication to perform in the band, and it's early mornings and rehearsals after school, concerts, and obviously performing on stage for a lot of different events. So these students show a high level of dedication to their craft. So the Stage 5 instrumental band scholarship goes to Alexander Marakis. Well done, sweetie. Just sing us to breath. And the Stage 6 Instrumental Band Scholarship goes to James Burt. Yep, here he is. Down the list of grants, sweetie. Again, I'd like to reiterate that this process was very competitive and a lot of really worthy students missed out, and we congratulate everybody who applied and, of course, all those students who received scholarships for next year. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Stedman and Mr. Grant. The next group of award recognises the contribution of dedicated ABHS staff. This will be presented by Julian Lesser. Tom Melrose has been an excellent contributor to the English faculty. Over the last 11 years, he has programmed and taught all levels of English courses, achieving exemplary results, which is a testament to his contribution of the subject area and the students that he has engaged. Tom has also pursued opportunities around the school, including welfare, relieving that in the head teacher welfare capacity on several extended occasions, and this year he willingly added to his job description the important school welfare role of year advisor of year 9, having only just completed the role for 6 years with the graduating class of 2022. He has also contributed to sport, having coached an extensive number of junior rugby and league tag teams in his time at Asquith Boys High School, with success in both sporting areas. His junior rugby sevens team completed the most recent winter season undefeated before narrowly going down in the grand final. Tom Melrose is well deserved of this award. He is a cornerstone of this school and is loved by staff, students, and the community. Rachel Parker has been a significant contributor and member of the HISI faculty since 2010. In that period, she has completed numerous educational and wellbeing roles, with her expertise in humanities areas in economics, business studies, and commerce. She has pursued additional training and is now also qualified as a careers advisor, and in that capacity has relieved at Asquith Boys High School and supported numerous boys with work experience opportunities and the transition to employment. Her ability to be flexible and her willingness to donate her time and skills in this numerous school-wide capacities does not go unnoticed. She is also professional and committed, always professional and committed, putting educational needs of her students at the forefront of her planning. Thank you. Please join me to congratulate and acknowledge these two wonderful ABHS staff who are being celebrated for today, for their work and contribution of their lives. I would now like to invite the school community to enjoy the performance My Shot by the Combined Wind Ensemble and Bradley Flood, conducted by Beth Smith.
I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just on my country. I'm young, scrappy and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I'ma get a scholarship to King's College. I probably shouldn't brag, but dang, I'm amazed and astonished. The problem is I got a lot of brains with no polish. I gotta holler just to be heard with every word. I drop knowledge, I'm a diamond in the rough. A shiny piece of coal, trying to reach my goal. My power of speech is unimpeachable. Only 19, but my mind is older. These newer city streets get colder. I shoulder every burden, every disadvantage. I have learned to manage. I have streets famished. That is the family spark into the flame. But dang, it's getting dark, so let me spell out the name. I am the A-L-E-X-A-N-D-E-R. We are meant to be a colony that runs independently. Meanwhile, Britain keeps bitten on us endlessly. Essentially, they tax us relentlessly. The King George turns around and runs a spending spree. He ain't ever gonna set his descendants free. So there will be a revolution in the century. I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just on my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just on my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. Everybody sing. Hey. Woo. And let them hear ya. Let's go. To the rooftops. Come on, come on, let's go. Rise up when you're living on your knees. You rise up to your brother that he's gonna rise up. To your sister that she's gonna rise up. When are these colonies gonna rise up? 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 Rise up. I'm past patiently waiting, I'm passionately smashing every expectation, every action's an act of creation. I'm laughing in the face of casualties and sorrow. For the first time I'm thinking past tomorrow. And I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just on my country, I'm young, scrappy and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. We're gonna rise up, time to take a shot. We're gonna rise up, time to take a shot. We're gonna, it's time to take a shot. It's time to take a shot. Take a shot. Take a shot. 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 It's time to take a shot. Time to take a shot. And I am not gonna waste my, not gonna waste my shot.
That was wonderful. Thank you to the Combined Wind Ensemble. This section of our ceremony is all about recognising excellence in student leadership and citizenship. At Asquith Boys, there are rich opportunities for students to be involved in leadership, which is invaluable for later life. The following awards recognise important qualities in our students. Many of these awards are supported by local community organisations and groups. It gives us great pleasure to recognise the wonderful leadership qualities demonstrated by students of Asquith Boys. These young men are the prospective community leaders of the future. I will now invite Chief Petty Officer David McGovern to present the first set of the Leadership and Citizenship Awards. The Hornsby District Rotary School Captain Award recognises the commitment and dedication to every aspect of representing and leading the student body of the school. The recipient of the award is, of course, our outgoing school captain, Josh Hegarty, who has been an outstanding leader to the student body and representative of the school. He has set the bar very high in terms of his exceptional qualities as a leader. Josh has led his year group and the entire school with dignity and commitment throughout 2023. He is an approachable leader who is loved by students and staff alike, whose efforts ensured the dignified departure of Year 12 was a positive celebration, and we are proud to have witnessed Joshua's growth as a leader over the past 12 months. I hope he's watching us from his holiday in Yamba, and please join me in thanking Josh for his service to the school. The Mervyn Brown Vice Captain Award was initiated by Mr. Grant in 2019 to recognise the effort, commitment and dedication required to support the student leadership team and uphold the values and integrity of the school within the student body in the demanding role of Vice Captain. The outgoing Vice Captain, Elliot Rossington, has been an outstanding member of the student executive team, supporting the school captain, Joshua Hegarty, and senior prefect, Luke Hansworth, as well as being a leader of the student body. Please join me in congratulating and thanking Elliot Rossington for his service to the school over the past 12 months. The Sergeant Alan Pierce Prefectship Memorial Trophy Award recognises the student who has been the most outstanding, reliable prefect and provides a role model to students of Asquith Boys High School. We congratulate Matthew Saliga, who has been nominated for this award by Mr. French for his excellence as a student leader. Coming up. The Hornsby Shire Council Senior SRC Award recognises the student who leads and organises the SRC in its actions. The recipient for 2023 has shown fantastic energy and dedication in leading the SRC with Mr. Campbell, as well as being an amazing guitarist who has participated in school mad nights throughout his time as a student of Asquith Boys. Please congratulate Liam Connolly. The School Service Award recognises a student for his service to the school and community. The 2023 School Service Award goes to a student who has shown throughout his 6 years at Asquith Boys High School his commitment to supporting our school in every way that he can. He led the student body and the school in 2023 as an avid campaigner for school spirit, participation, and takes great pride in being a good man. We are proud to again recognise Josh Hegarty. The recipient of the 2023 School Spirit Award has shown exceptional commitment to encouraging participation across school and community throughout his time at school. This student has demonstrated his excellent commitment through his enthusiastic efforts and energy, particularly in his senior years. Please congratulate the School Spirit Award recipient for 2023, Murray Harrison. The Hornsby Lions Club Ted Tricker Leadership and School Service Award recognises a student who shows exceptional qualities in leading and working to support his school and local community. The student was also nominated for and will receive this morning his Macquarie University Year 11 Emerging Leaders Award. The Hornsby Lions Tetricker Leadership and School Service Award goes to a student who has shown fantastic energy and commitment in his leadership. Please congratulate Jaden Mark. We now have four very prestigious awards provided by the Australian Defence Forces, the ADF Long Tan and Future Innovators Awards. Chief Petty Officer David McGovern from the ADF will present these awards now. This next young man is a student who demonstrated both commitment and generosity to our school. He has displayed leadership of the hall crew, is heavily involved in team sports both inside and outside school, and supports all school community events. He is a team player who cooperates and communicates within the hall crew to stage and support school events, recently as a newly elected prefect. He demonstrates excellence in appearance and respectful behaviour and has shown himself to be a resourceful problem solver with the physical logistics of school events, as well as possessing expertise with the audiovisual workings around the school. He has proven himself to be an excellent leader who has worked with fellow students to support school events during his 4 years at Asquith Boys. He is a highly resourceful young man who collaborates well with others, and we congratulate and recognise him for his excellence in teamwork, service and problem solving. The winner of the Year 10 ADF Long Tan Award for Excellence in Leadership and Teamwork for 2023 is Patrick Kilkelly. This final young man is a student who demonstrated exemplary leadership through his everyday actions. He is a dedicated and hardworking student who has extended himself to support his school and its events both within and outside of school hours. He has been conspicuous in his communication skills, leadership, teamwork, and collaboration. He has displayed integrity in the use of his expertise and continual support of the ABHS community, and we again congratulate and recognise in his absence Joshua Hegarty for the Year 12 ADF Long Tan Award. Okay, I'm hoping it's right from here on because I can see a little bit of a typo in here or some errors. Oscar? Is Oscar Rongberg next? Yes? Okay, that's fine. Okay. He's a hardworking, academic and articulate student who has dedicated himself to excellence across the 4 years of his schooling at Asquith Boys. He is a student who works hard and strives to do his personal best at all times. He is a high-achieving student who is absolutely passionate about computers, maths and science. He's also amazingly creative and a gifted artist. This young man has designed and built technical solutions to IT problems for the school and has an understanding of all things IT that is well beyond his years. It's my pleasure to announce, and it's no surprise now, Oscar Rongberg as the winner of the Year 10 ADF Award for 2023. The next STEM Future Innovators Award winner is a Year 12 student who has engaged himself in his studies with dedication and demonstrated resilience. He is highly motivated, dedicated, and diligent about IT and has been instrumental in designing and building technical IT solutions to problems around the school and with school events. He has demonstrated outstanding problem solving, persistence, and teamwork in his efforts, collaborating with and leading others with confidence. The Year 12 ADF STEM Future Innovators Award winner for 2023 is Tom Eisner. The Barara Lions Citizenship and Community Service Award recognises a student who shows exceptional commitment and reliability in the service of his school and local communities. We present the Barara Lion Citizenship and Community Service Award to a student who has shown the most laudable level of commitment, service, integrity and dedication. Please congratulate Jai Duncan. The Asquith Boys High School Public Speaking Award recognises a student for his ability to address large groups in an engaging and dignified manner. This year we have two award winners. The Junior Public Speaking Award recipient for 2023 is Jesse Loffel. The senior award winner is Luke Handsworth, who, as our former senior prefect, needs no introduction. Please join me in congratulating him for his senior public speaking award recipient for 2023. Well done, mate. Looking sharp. The Member for Barara Prize for Outstanding Citizenship Award recognises a junior student who is an exceptional citizen of the school and local community. The recipient has shown himself to be an exceptionally committed citizen of ABHS and the local community, demonstrating a real generosity of spirit. Please congratulate Tyler Truscott Jones. The 2023 Hornsby RSL Award for Selfless Service recognises the commitment and dedication of a student who works for the good of others rather than for himself. Working to serve your community and your country is a foundational military virtue and was targeted as a worthy value to recognise in our students. This student has demonstrated empathy and understanding, as well as showing support for his peers and his school. He has shown dedication to ABHS, its students and staff, as well as the local community through his good nature and kind heart, and was under no obligation to act in this way. It is with great pleasure that I ask you to join me in congratulating Liam Pearce. The Member for Hornsby Matt Keane Citizenship Award is a prize for extraordinary citizenship in a senior student and recognises someone who is an outstanding citizen of the school community and wider local community. Please congratulate Riley Heisman. And a big thank you to Chief Petty Officer David McGovern. Thank you. This part of the ceremony is where we recognise the highest level of achievement that has been attained by students in Year 11 and 12. And I'll ask Mr. Grant to present this final group of awards. Firstly, the Les Miller Trophy for Perseverance recognises a student who has demonstrated exceptional commitment, tenacity and perseverance. This year we would like to all recognise a student who has shown resilience when faced with adversity and always approached every day as a new opportunity. He treats everyone with respect and kindness, so let's please congratulate Aidan Manticle. Secondly, the Year 11 Academic High Achiever Award is nominated by the Year Advisor for the student with the highest academic achievement across all of their subjects. The recipient of the award has shown himself to be a fine and dedicated student and has worked with drive and maturity to excel. Please congratulate Thomas Salinas. The Reuben F. Scarf Award is nominated by all staff and executive members for the Year 12 student who has demonstrated the most outstanding commitment across his senior years, particularly in Year 12. The 2023 award goes to a quiet and hardworking student who worked with commitment, maturity, and self-drive towards his goal to achieve success in Year 12. He excelled across all of his subjects and is well deserving of this award. Congratulations to Roy Treves. The AMPOL All-Rounder Award is nominated by staff and executive members as the student of most outstanding excellence across all aspects of school life in Year 12. The award in 2023 goes to a wonderful leader, student and sportsman who has worked hard to achieve his best and present an excellent example for others to follow. And in his absence, please congratulate Elliot Rossington. Finally, we present the 2023 Asquith Boys High School All-Round Academic Achievement Award, which recognises a fine student who has achieved at the very highest level. This year, the award, voted unanimously by staff and the executive, went to a student who has set a very high standard for others to follow, and we are proud of this young man who has been a part of our school community. Congratulations to Vladimir Zuev Elbaka. Thank you very much, Mr. Grant. Please join me in congratulating all today's award winners while we hand you back to Riley.
Thank you, Mr. Phillip. On behalf of our school community, I would like to offer an enormous thanks to many people. First and foremost, to our principal, Mr. Grant, who has overseen many visible improvements around the school grounds over this last year. These include 3 brand new woodwork rooms, which will be completed over the holidays, replacement of the timber TAS deck, replacing the timber frame windows in A block in 2024, the continued pursuit of a multi-purpose centre indoor facility for our sport and PE classes, of special mention in the school to work and construction classes, who have continued construction of the retaining wall along the oval and around the school's tree of knowledge, upgraded the school oval grandstand, and completed the Jersey Street reception area. These are things which should be communicated outside our school gates. Secondly, we would like to thank our guest presenters for being here in person with us today and our generous community supporters for their prizes. School Captain Jaden Mark, Vice Captain Samuel Kingston, and I would like to recognise this continuous support you have given to students of Asquith Boys. Lastly from me, and on behalf of all of us up here on stage, I would also like to acknowledge the staff who work behind the scenes to make this special event happen. They include, but are not limited to, Tracy Booker, Rachel Parker, Manuel Cabrera and the music students, Catherine Holder, Aaron Hendry, Jim French, Kim Timmons. Thank you also to the tech team and crew of Linda Robson and Brad Flood, as well as the hall crew for the enormous effort to bring the presentation ceremony to viewers wherever you may be. And I now hand you back to Jaden for the culmination of the proceedings.
Thank you, Mr. Phillip, for the work that you have done and for being MC for this ceremony for the last 7 years. That concludes the official part of today's proceedings. On behalf of all staff and students, I would like to thank all of you, the parents, caregivers, and guests of our wonderful school community for attending in person and taking the time to join us online to recognise the superb achievements of the students at our wonderful school. We look forward to seeing you again in 2024. Goodbye and enjoy a safe, restful holiday and a happy new year. I now ask all present to stand up until the official party has left the hall. Enjoy Explorations, performed by the Combined Wind Ensemble.